Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use Spline to create a 3D glass cube like the one that you can see here. So this is done using the glass layer and the depth layer and a couple of other tricks that we will be using to simulate this real-time glass reflection on Spline. Alright, let's begin. Alright, so the first thing is to create the floor. So I'm going to use the same rectangle that I have here. I'm going to rotate the rectangle 90 degrees, and then I'm going to use 5,000 units in X and 5,000 units in Y. It's going to be a very huge rectangle. So I'm going to make it this to be called a floor. And then in here in the color, I'm going to use this color. I'm also going to change the lighting to be fun, and this to be 0 and this to be 0. Then in the blending mode, I'm going to use overlay. Alright, so I'm going to also lock the floor so it's not interrupting my selection. So now I want to create a cube, so I'm going to just click and drag, and I'm going to place the cube in 0 0 0, so it's easier for me to position. And then I want to use 100 units in all directions because I want to use a grid of 100 units, which is actually the default on Spline. So I'm going to zoom in here a little bit, and now I want to move the position here to be 50, so it's above the ground. Now at this point, what I need to do is that I just need to press Command D to duplicate, and then I can start moving this object to match the other side in here. And then I'm going to select both of these cubes while holding Shift, and then I'm going to press Command D again, and then I'm going to move the other cubes to the top. So I'm going to repeat this process, and then now we have the 8 cubes. Now I'm going to select all of these cubes in here. I'm going to move them below, and I want to change this to be 4, so they have a round corner there of 4 units. Now I'm going to enable here now the snapping to be on the grid, and then I'm going to move all of these cubes a little bit so they're going to match the grid itself. So it's hardly noticeable, but basically it's now matching my grid perfectly, which is what I want. Okay, so now I want to move my light. So my light is gonna be in minus 280 in X, 300 units in Y, and 200 units in Z. I also want to enable here soft shadows, and then in my light in here I want to use let's say something around 5.34. That should be good enough for now. Alright, so now I want to create the glass for this cube. So I'm going to create a new material asset. And this is going to be called glass. And for these objects in here, I'm going to use the glass. And now I just want to start editing this glass material, right? So I'm going to create here a new glass layer like this. By default, you won't be able to see much because everything is transparent. So let's change the materials here to be 100 units in blurriness, 250 units in thickness, and 1.08 in refraction. So you can see a little bit now right there if you move. All right, so what we need now is the reflection, right? So right now we are not reflecting the light. So let's do a couple of things first. So let's create a Fresnel layer here. And this is gonna be black instead. And here is gonna be 0.14. So it's a little more darker on the edges. And then I'm going to use a blending mode of overlay. So it's actually giving a little bit more volume. And then now I'm going to add a matcap layer here. So a matcap layer is basically like a projection. It means material capture. So it's more like a projection of a texture. And then I'm going to select one of the defaults here, which is this one here at the end. And what I want is I want to use a blending mode of a screen. So now it's going to be acting like a reflection on top of this. So you can see now it looks a little bit more like glass. All right, so now that the glass is ready, I want to start adding a little bit more visual complexity. So I'm going to create another material here, and this is going to be called blue. And for this material, I want to add a depth layer here. And this depth layer is going to be something like a blue color by default, something like this. And then on the other end, it's going to be somewhere like a pink color. Let's assign this material to this object here. Yeah, so now we have this color, and what I want now is I want to move this color a little bit so you can see what is actually this color. As you can see, there's a little bit of pink there, so I really like this gradient. We can repeat the same process that we did with the glass, which is we can add the matcap layer on the top of everything. and then we can select the same texture here and use a screen as well. And now it's reflecting light in the same way. So it's looking a little better. So I'm going to apply the same for another one in here in the bottom. So I'm going to select the one. So it looks a little bit more interesting now, because now we can have something place on the back. And now what I want to do is I want to add a little bit more complexity on the cubes itself. So I'm going to switch to the object snapping again, and then I'm going to reduce the size of this object by a half right there. And then I'm going to press Command D to duplicate, and then I can move this object to match on the other side. And then I can repeat the same process for this one in here. So I'm just going to make this a half, and then Command D to duplicate, and then we can move this to the bottom here. So now we have a little bit more complexity here. And what I want is that I want this color in here to be yellow. I'm going to select first the blue one in here, and then I'm just going to detach. And I'm going to disable this because I don't really want this. Instead, I'm going to be using just a normal yellow color here. And then this is going to be an overlay. So it's going to be something like this. It's very, very bright. And for this in here, I actually want the same, but let's detach this and let's change the colors. So instead of blue, what I want here is maybe something that is a little bit more like pink. And then for the top part, I want to be yellow. So it's gonna be like matching the yellow on the other side. So one thing that we're missing here is the depth to be actually below the lighting. So let's just change this to be an overlay in here. So you can see now it looks a little bit more intense. And I actually want to do the same in here because this was not really properly blending. So we can use the overlay in here, and then we can adjust the colors just a little bit so it doesn't feel too bright. So finally, I want to change the gradient here a little bit so it moves in a different direction. Yeah, something like this, I think it could work. So basically, there is a little bit more pink inside. So I kind of like this better. All right, so I think we have something that is looking pretty nice. And what I want now is that I want to actually create like these lines going across the floor. So in order to create the grid lines, I'm going to use a rectangle. So I'm going to just create a rectangle here. And this is going to be just, this is going to be just like 1 unit in X and 5,000 units in Y. And let's just make sure that we have something that makes sense here for now. 0, 0. And this is gonna be like 0.1 in Y because this is just right above the floor. So now I just want to use the cloner here to duplicate this line. And let's just go to linear here in the cloner. So this could be maybe like 50. And then here is gonna be 100. So it's the amount of space between each of the clones. All right, so now I want to move this minus 2000, and then I want to duplicate this rectangle, and let's also rename this to be lines X, and this is going to be lines C, right? All right, so this time what I want is I want to rotate these lines minus 90 degrees, and it's going to be 0 in X and minus 2000 units in C. So now we have the other side. All right, so those two objects here, I'm going to be creating a new material for them. This is gonna be grid lines. And for this grid line, I just want to click here on the floor to kind of like get the same color. But then I'm going to enable here phone. We don't want any shininess. And we do want the overlay. And instead of this color, we can make it a little darker like this. Yeah, I think that's a lot better. All right, so now what I want to do is that I want to duplicate some of the cubes and start adding more details around the composition. So I'm going to enable again my grid snapping, and then I'm going to press Command D on this cube, and I'm going to move it a little bit to here. And then I want to change the size of this cube to be somewhere around 25. Then I can just duplicate this cube again and can put it on different position. All right, so I want to convert this material here into an asset so I can reuse this. So this is gonna be pink, yellow. Then we can select these two here, and I can use the pink yellow. And then for these two, I actually want to move them a little bit to here, and this one is gonna be blue. And then what I want to do is I want to duplicate this one in here, and I want to change the size to be a little like twice. And then I want to make something really, really small right there. and then I can duplicate this again. Then maybe I can put it around here. Then I can use again for this, I can change the size to be smaller, and then I can also use here the pink yellow color. So one last thing is that make sure that your background is actually the same color as your floor, so you can just click anywhere and then you can get your color there. Right, it looks like we have basically everything ready, and if we go to the play mode, we can see how it looks. One potential next step from here is that you can put something like this on a website. So if you're interested in integrating your 3D designs inside your website, you can check out this tutorial that we did before, in which you can use Spline in combination with Framer to create a 3D website. All right, I hope you like this tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye bye.